Avery Brooks says his workflow has changed a lot since the start of the coronavirus pandemic. He says his already lengthy shifts are now more demanding as he's been caring for patients recovering from the virus.
There's a lot more, I'd say, mental exertion with just making sure that we're careful every day and keeping ourselves safe.
Avery Brooke is in his second year of nursing at Sacred Heart. Before the pandemic, he was treating patients recovering from sepsis, but for now, his duties have changed.
It varies every day because I work on the ninth floor and we get a wide variety of patients up there. Most recently, we've been the COVID unit.
During his 12-hour shifts, he's caring for 3 to 4 patients at a time. And when treating for coronavirus, Brooks says there's not much downtime.
We have to be a lot more careful because they, unlike a typical flu patient, the coronavirus patients I've seen have changed dramatically, really rapidly.
Checking their vitals and levels of oxygen in their blood has become critical.
You have to spot that and kind of jump on it real quickly because they'll go downhill very fast.
So I asked Brooke about the greatest challenge she's faced with this heightened level of responsibility.
We're trying to keep ourselves safe. We're trying to keep other patients in the hospital safe. And there's a lot of unknowns about this virus.
He has a wife and 3 boys at home, so walking through the door at the end of a work day means quickly taking off his scrubs.
With this, I take extra precautions. I'll take off my scrubs, put them right in the wash, and then take a shower before I touch anybody in the house.
And for everyone who's offered appreciation and support, Brooks says thank you.
I love what I do, and it's my calling, but it's been wonderful, really.
Now, Brooke and all the other nurses I talked to this past week said some version of, we're not heroes, we're just workers doing our job. But they do say they're extremely grateful for all the support they've been getting from their neighbors, patients, and families.